According to the company's site agent at the Otavi-Tumeb railway line, Gilbert Nashima, thieves are stealing fish plates, rail fasteners, as well as e-clip springs. This, he says, is a cause of concern and pleaded with scrapyard owners countrywide not to buy such stolen items.
The dangers to that is that not only is it that it is it's government infrastructure that we're actually destroying, is that it could derail a train, and trains carry commodities that skyrocket values of to the hundreds of millions. So this is important to the public to understand that not only are they destroying the country's infrastructure, but they're causing damage to the railway authority, which is Transnamib.
Despite the increase of theft, the company has managed to complete the construction of a 10-kilometer railway line by upgrading it with 48 kg rails to conform to the Southern African Development Community standards. Nashima says this railway line was last upgraded in 1958 with 30 kg rails. Government contracted the company to rehabilitate the railway lines from Kransberg in the Erongo region via Kalkveld to Tumeb routes.
We have completed 40 kilometers of track on this Kransberg-Tumeb section, which is aligned to the SADC standard. Basically, what that means now is trains on that certain section can carry commodity at 18.5 tons per axle.
This railway line transports sulfuric acid, fuel and blast stones from the mines in Oshikoto to the coastal town of Walvis Bay on a daily basis. Construction and rehabilitation works on the sites started in 2013 to complete a total of 391 kilometers of railway lines.